So I came out to feed hay this evening. You'll notice a little surprise over here. This is our first lamb of the lambing season. I don't want to say the year because we had lambs obviously earlier this year. And it is a boy. We'll have to. Mama's right here, number 37. But mark that down in our registry. So as you can tell, they sound like stay there, mama. They sound like babies, actually, like human babies. Everybody else looks pretty healthy. Nobody looks like they're gonna pop, except for her. You can tell when their genitalia starts to get swollen. That's a pretty good sign. And then obviously if they have udders, their bag will fill up completely. So, a good Christmas surprise, an early Christmas present. It's the 22nd. So, unfortunately there was only a single, but it's okay. It's healthy. So just to kind of show you what we're talking about, we have a brown one right here. She has a very full bag. And that is a very good indicator to us that she's going to give birth soon. Generally once they're full like that, you know, within a couple of days, they generally give birth. But hers isn't, her bag's not full, but it's obviously there. And then this one right here, we call her Nigerian because she's colored like a Nigerian, there's a deer from Nigeria that looks like this. But anyways, her genitalia is very puffy, if you look. I know you probably can't see very well on this camera, but it looks swollen.
One of the sheep just took a bunch of hay from another place and moved it to another place.
There it is. Lambing has begun.
And set it down.
You guys excited for lambing to begin?
Yeah, Cheyenne. Did you tell Daddy what you asked me?
What'd you ask?
What'd you ask me when I told you that we had a lamb?
I asked if it was black, white, or brown.
And then which mommy is it? Is it doing okay?
Yeah.
All without taking a breath in between.
We have to watch. We got lucky that it's good weather right now, so.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Good morning, everyone.
cloudy, breezy day. I'm actually just doing my normal chores right now, and then I'm going to go take... We've got some fencing that we're going to take down, and we're going to move it somewhere else. Our flock's size has expanded, and we don't really need paddocks that are as small as what we have set up right now. So we're going to expand them, make them all about 5 acres, because that's what we're going to grow to. It's about a 350 ewe flock, plus the breeding rams. So get to that size, and then we'll stay there. Probably won't increase from there. I don't know, we'll see. Doubtful, but never know. So let's get started with our morning chores. Everybody's hungry. Let's go see our sheep. That's what Chrissy would call. Probably gonna start following us. These sheeple. She's already got her babies. She has a bag started. She definitely has a bag. No bag. No bag. Hey, mamas. Made that for you. It's not fresh anymore, but. Woolier ones, it's a little harder to see because you can't see them from the side or anything. Just a quick walk through. Let's see what everybody's doing. That's a ram. See you next to her. She has a bag started. Oh, nope. She has a bag started. For the most part, it seems for us, we usually have one that'll give birth like a week or so, maybe 2 weeks before everybody else. And then we'll have another one that gives birth, like I said, about a week or two after that first one. And then it seems like within that third week, everybody starts giving birth, which is kind of a nightmare. She has a bag. Talking about, if you haven't watched our channel before, what we're talking about with the bag is the udder. When the udder is filled and looks like a balloon essentially, so like you can see hers is filling but it's not full. Let's see if I can find the brown mama to show you what a full one would look like. And now the other thing, so hers is full but she also already had her babies. So but the other thing to think about, they can wonder bag you. So essentially they have a very, either no bag or a very little one. They give birth and then their bag shows up within a day or so later. Maud has done that to us before. She had absolutely no bag, no signs of giving birth, and bam, we woke up the next day and we had lambs and no idea where they came from. So, well, better get started on this, I guess. So we're gonna take this fence line right here. We're gonna take out, and not this one, but the one right back there. We're gonna take it out, and then the one next to it. So that'll be about a 5-acre paddock. that's gonna be a 5 acre paddock. This is like 4.3 acres or something like that. That was 3.7 acres. And then all the ones that we're making on the property we just bought this year, we're gonna make that 5 acre paddocks as well. We're very close to it. So, MK's out here supervising. MK's our outside cat, barn cat. He's very friendly. He does a really good job at getting mice. So I'm very happy with him. And he's actually really good about not getting on your vehicle. Occasionally he does, but usually he doesn't. If it's really cold out and you just get home from work, obviously the vehicle's warm, he'll get on. But other than that, he does a really good job. I can't complain. And then you got George over there mixing in with the sheeple. Alright, I better stop talking and get to work. All right, so it took me just over an hour and, I'll just say just over an hour because I fed animals too, I guess, during that time, to take down, oh, I don't know, 200-ish feet of field fence. At the beginning, you could see that I was using the tractor to pull the T-post, but the farther down the hill I came, the softer the ground was getting, and I was like, well, you know, maybe I could just pull those out easily by hand, and it was easy enough. So only two more fences to go, but they're a lot longer. They're close to 400 feet probably. So let's get started.
in there. You can do that stuff while I'm making dinner.
I'm putting it in there now.
Who made it? Huh? Who made that?
So as you can see, this week was actually pretty productive. We had three lambs born. We had taken down just over 800 feet of fencing, close to 900 feet. We'll use that actually for the new paddocks that we set up to. And then we had a ram that is no longer needed here at our farm, and someone locally bought him. And we dropped him off at the butcher for them. So it's a sad cycle of life, but he was older. And the fact is that he bred the ewes last year. And we have a lot of the ewes that were born from last year's lambs. We still have them here. And we don't want them to breed with him, because I don't know which ones he is the father of and which ones he's not. So the simple thing to do is just to switch out rams occasionally. So that's what we did. It's just how the things work around here. If we had another farm nearby, it'd be something simple that we could maybe swap rams every other year. But it's just not how it works. Unfortunately, we're the only ones around here that really have them. And it's just how it's going to work out for our farm. But he served his purpose. He had a good life here. And now he's helping another family. So, hope you enjoyed the video this week. So, if they liked the video, what should they do?
If you liked the video, push the thumbs up button.
Okay, and then what if they have questions about the video? What could they do?
If you have questions about the video, leave a comment down below.
And then if they like the content on our channel?
If you subscribe.
So think about it. If you subscribe, you could see that cute mug almost weekly. Pretty good deal.
Bye-bye.